If you're looking for rates as low as this and quick approval on a home equity credit line account, listen to Bud Bash.
When you need a second mortgage, there's only one phrase you need to hear.
Mr. Anderson, your loan was approved.
Call the Personal Mortgage Corporation at 1-800-DIAL-PMC. No weeks of waiting, no application fees. You'll get an answer in 24 hours. Don't worry if others have turned you down. Call 1-800-DIAL-PMC, Personal Mortgage Corporation. When it comes to second mortgages, we approve.
Hey, Mr. Perfect, I heard you're asking questions of the other wrestlers. Hey, who is this guy, Narcissus? What do you know about him? Is he truly beyond perfect? Is it possible for anyone to have those qualities superior to mine? Well, let me answer your questions, Mr. Perfect. Comparing you to Narcissus would be like comparing ice cream to horse manure. Now, I know horse manure has its place in this world, even perfect horse manure. But perfect, there is only room in this world for one human being that is truly anatomically perfect, that is physically and mentally superior beyond imagination. Why, Ric Flair and I both agree that Michelangelo could not capture on canvas the stupendous qualities of Narcissus. He could not sculpt from marble the metamorphic qualities of Narcissus. Why, Narcissus is so beyond perfect, it's like he's from another galaxy. So, Mr. Perfect, when you see me unveil Narcissus at the Royal Rumble, you are going to think, if you can, that Narcissus is from another world.
Well, I must say, Bobby Heenan certainly has piqued my interest. I can't wait to take a look at this guy, Narcissus.
Let's see that the proof is in the pudding, if he's got something great showing.
Well, we'll all see it at the Royal Rumble. His name yet to be announced, but nonetheless, I am in the middle of, well, I guess maybe it's a rose between two thorns, so to speak. The two gentlemen to my right and left, no doubt participating in the Royal Rumble in a couple of weeks out in Sacramento, California.
It's either that or a ham sandwich.
I see. You say a rose between.
Every man for himself. No friends. Only foes. It's tag team partner against tag team partner. You're going to be hit from all sides. And well, whoever wins that Royal Rumble will in fact face the WWF champion at WrestleMania.
I have no problem with that. I've been battling against all odds all my life.
Lance Cassidy with a nice drop kick a few moments ago on Petrovsky.
I'd like to see this Lance Cassidy get in the Royal Rumble, because I'd like to just wrap that long stringy hair of his around my head and pull it out by the roots.
Let's not be talking about stringy hair.
And by the way, we just got confirmation that Raymond Rougeau will in fact conduct an interview with our clown who's been about ringside and has caused actually so much trouble here in the WWF as of late.
That ought to be an exciting interview.
Pokrovsky puts on the brakes. Drop kick, nicely done. And our drag takedown. That's Cassidy in control.
I don't think that's a good idea to interview the clown. You know, it's sort of like a kid in Santa Claus. Why make the clown speak? Part of his mystique, part of his allure is the fact that it's sort of like Marcel Marceau.
Are you scared of your own shadow, Jerry? Is that your problem right there? You don't want to see anybody get called on the carpet?
Let's not make this personal. No, I, for one, am very anxious to hear this clown speak.
And me, too. Just happen to be in agreement with you, Vince McMahon, just at this particular time.
You see the look on the face of that clown last week when Crush put the big bad mouth on him?
I saw a big smile on his face, as usual.
Well, a little bit later on, he did a nice maneuver by Lance Cassidy. And a standing drop kick again. Andre
knocked down. Brodsky having his problems with Lance Cassidy.
I predict that the clown apologizes to Crush.
That'd be a smart thing to do.
I'd like to apologize to him right now, and I didn't do anything.
He's a big man, this Crush. The Kona Crush. Scoop. Nice maneuver there by Petrovsky. Off the rope, a little slow on the mark.
A man from Texas, Lance Cassidy, in the World Wrestling Federation. You can bet he's getting ready for the Royal Rumble, possibly, if he enters it. I'm not sure if he is or not.
I doubt if he'll get in there. He's heard that I'm in it, so.
You almost said that without stuttering. Are you a little nervous, there, Jerry Lawler?
No, I'm not nervous.
And boom! To participate in the 30-man Royal Rumble. And Lance Cassidy just might be one of them. Let's go back and take another look.
Lance Cassidy, the man from Texas.
That was a nice dropkick.
Dropkick the man right over the top rope, then attack him from behind.
Yeah. What about that?
Well, he jumped on him from behind. That's not impressive.
Oh, no? I'll tell you what is impressive. That right there, the cover of the WWF magazine, you might say. It's a perfect cover. Available newsstands everywhere this coming Tuesday.
For weeks now, I'm sure everyone here has noticed this strange clown that has been showing up in arenas all over the country. Well, we'd like to find out what this clown is made of. What is he all about? And what does he want here in the World Wrestling Federation? So let's bring out the clown.
This is going to be most interesting. Wait a minute, what's this? His arm's in a sling.
Okay, Mr. Clown, you must have a name.
Yeah, Doink.
Doink. Your name is Doink.
Yeah, Doink.
Doink. What kind of a name is Doink?
It's a good name.
Okay, I'd like to straighten out a few things here. First of all, you tripped the big boss man on his way to the ring. You put a mop into Tonka's eye. You threw water on Marty Jannetty.
You needed a bath anyway. Oh, don't forget the bananas underneath Beckham's feet.
You know, you're the only one laughing here. Clowns are supposed to be funny. Clowns are supposed to make children laugh. I don't see anybody laughing but you.
Hey, isn't that what it's all about? I just love to come out to the arenas and look around and look at all the little kids' faces. They're all smiling. They're all jumping up and down. They're all wondering what Doink's going to do next. And I love to walk to them and play with them, give them little balloons, give them little tricks, do little tricks for them. And then I like to look at them and their little smiles. And I like to just take those smiles right away.
Oh, that's despicable. As a matter of fact, didn't Crush give you a severe warning last week right here? Now, it's one thing to pull your practical jokes on wrestlers who can defend themselves, but it's another thing to pull your pranks on these youngsters out here.
Hey, I'm having a good time. I'm laughing. I'm having a good time.
Well, you're the only one that's having a good time. You know what the bottom line is? Your jokes are always at someone else's expense.
You know what? I don't care if these are little kids' expenses. I don't care if it's those people's up there expenses or those people's up there expenses. As a matter of fact, I don't even care if they're your expense. Yeah.
Look at this. Look at this. You think that's funny too, I suspect.
That must be your court gesture, King Jerry Lawler, right there.
He would make a great one. He abuses me.
I don't know how this clown hurt his arm. As far as I'm concerned, he's hurt enough feelings around here, that's for sure. This guy's sick.
No, he's
yeah,
funny.
Yeah, no, he's sick.
I don't like him.
I don't either.
I do.
Where do we start?
How about his knee?
That's his face. If that's his face, what's this?